You're under arrest for the murder of Rick Weber.
Lucky's under arrest.
What are the charges?
Murder.
Sonny Corinthos will never touch me.
And why is that?
Because I have something he wants.
I am trying to help you.
I can take care of myself.
AJ's not worth it.
He is to me.
I want you to watch over Courtney.
Done. By chance, bring me any takeout, did you? Food in this place hasn't improved since the last time I've been in here.
It's good to see you here. Lost your sense of humor, Lucky. After 24 hours of incarceration, most of my clients do.
Yeah, well, mine's fading fast. You know, I'm beginning to think that Scott Baldwin personally picked that cell next to those guys that won't shut their mouths.
Maybe he's trying to wear you down. Maybe he's trying to get you to admit to who really killed Rick Weber. Clearly, that could be your father, correct?
I didn't kill Rick Weber. I haven't spoken to anybody who did, and I haven't certainly spoken to anybody who has confessed to killing Rick Weber.
If you think that this room is wired, this conversation is being taped, that kind of civil rights violation would get this case thrown out in court, and I can assure you Scott Baldwin doesn't want that to happen. If you want me to help you, you're going to have to tell me everything, and I need to hear that from you now, not from Scott Baldwin later. You said that you and Nicholas found Rick Weber's body in the garage attic, but you chose not to call the police. Why is that? Is that because you know that your father did it? Lucky? That conversation, that phone call that Nicholas got that was supposedly from Laura talking about how she and Luke were on a honeymoon, what was that about? Have you had any contact with your parents? Lucky, I know that you didn't do this, and I know that Nicholas didn't do this, but Scott Baldwin, he will convince himself that one of you did it unless a more likely suspect emerges.
Fine. You want a suspect? I'll point fingers. How about Scott Baldwin?
Looks like we got a murder scene.
No one's allowed up here.
No, you know what? It's okay. I'm sure the DA won't mind.
Hey, hold him at the door.
I tried to stop. What's your hurry there, Nicholas? You come to confess your part in Rick Weber's murder?
You know, not that I have any problems with the accommodations or the room service, but do I get to know why you're keeping me here?
If you had some place to be, you shouldn't have trespassed.
I came to tell you information. I came to sell your boss information about Sonny Corinthos. Business information. Not whether Sky Quartermain and Jasper Jacks love each other or how much Sonny and his wife fight. You and this lady that you work for are chasing for information that I don't have. I don't know why anybody falls in love or they split up or stay together. But I can tell you who Sonny does business with and how much he and Jax hate each other. But all these questions you keep asking me about the condition of these people's hearts, I don't have a clue.
Your insights so far have been vitally important and very interesting.
Important to whom?
Here you go. Keep the change.
Would you like help getting your bags to the car?
You know what? I think we got it. The car's just right up front. Thanks.
Carly?
Carly, I need you to get a message to Jason immediately.
By the time I got to the Oasis last night, Courtney was already gone. So I checked. She works tonight, 10 to 2. I'll be there to make sure nothing happens to her.
And try to stay out of her sight, but be ready if anybody lays their hand on Courtney. I want you to jump in, but, you know, I don't want you to do anything crazy. Just do what you got to do to take care of the situation. I don't want her any more hurt or humiliated than the situation demands. You get what I'm saying?
Get out of my way. Sonny, I'm here. Now he knows.
What do you want?
I found this in the closet of my apartment. Tailor-made, very nice. I was gonna trash, but I decided to be civilized. I'm gonna say this politely. You're not welcome in my home. I don't care if Courtney's your sister. You stay away.
Gold Formula Beautiful Hair Breck is back.
Breck is back. The bottle, the fragrance, the rich Breck lather that leaves my hair feeling clean, soft, and manageable. Breck is back.
Try Beautiful Hair Breck, and your hair can be beautiful, too.
Wouldn't it be great to have a fresh, clean washcloth from Johnson's every bath time? And wouldn't it be great if you never had to wash it? Introducing Johnson's head-to-toe gentle cleansing cloths, the best thing to happen to your baby since the disposable diaper.
Hi, Darla Hahn here with new gorgeous lip color that you can't kiss off. It stays on all day and won't dry your lips out. It's called Lasting Lips and was created by Italian makeup designer Mario De Luigi, giving you rich color and luxurious shine. It's a one-step application, dries in seconds, and doesn't come off until you decide to take it off. Other lipsticks need to be blotted, they smudge, and bleed feathering into lines. The color gets onto your teeth and comes off all the time. With Lasting Lips, you can kiss with confidence and enjoy the whole night without leaving a trace. It's finally possible to enjoy dinner without smudging a glass or having to touch up. Lasting Lips won't stain your clothes or your loved ones. You'll feel free to smile and feel beautiful all day long. It takes you from sunrise to sunset and into the night without ever having to reapply. Lasting Lips won't smudge or rub off. You would never do this with normal lipsticks. It shines, feels light, and it's waterproof, so you can literally wear it anywhere and never worry about it coming off or staining. The secret's in the combination of unique color and shimmering gloss that, when applied, looks like it was just put on no matter how long you've been wearing it. And because it's water-based, it's kind to your lips. Similar products contain alcohol that dry your lips and sell for up to $15 each. Call now and you'll receive two colors, the ruby red and the copper rose, all for just $19.99. But if you call within the next 5 minutes, we'll double the value. That's four designer colors, the ruby red, the copper rose, the soft mauve, and the golden bronze, a $60 value, all for just $19.99. So call this number right now. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-821-2288 to order Lasting Lips, and we'll include two extra designer colors for you with your order. That's four fabulous colors for only $19.99. Call 1-800-821-2288.
Let them all come out.
Never hurt anybody.
Of course it's meant to be.
I'm losing you, and I don't know how to stop it.
Port Charles Secrets. Today at 8:30, only on SoapNet.
There comes a time when a man must face his greatest fear.
Teenage daughters.
Thank heaven.
Stop yelling at me!
Sweetie.
What?
Problem in the coven? Every
day. Your daughter's becoming women.
No.
John Ritter returns to ABC.
Ew, look at his pants.
I know.
All right!
In 8 Simple Rules for Dating My Teenage Daughter, a new comedy, Tuesdays, 8, 7 Central, this fall on ABC.
I have been leaving messages all over for Jason, and he hasn't called me back. I have something very important to tell him. Will you please call him for me?
Leticia, will you please take Michael to the car? Thanks. I'll meet you guys out there, okay? Oh, okay. Okay. Listen, if Jason isn't returning your calls, then there's probably a reason for this.
No, this isn't about me.
It's about business. Has someone threatened you?
No.
Okay, then listen to Jason, do what he asks, and stay away, okay? The last thing he needs is for you distracting him right now.
Do you really think I'd be asking for your advice if this was about romance? Listen, I know something that could possibly save Jason's life.
I gave you a chance to prove you gave a damn about your sister.
Proof to you? Is that what you're talking about?
I came to you when she was missing. I call it a test, and you failed. I mean, you didn't care whether she was hurt right. or kidnapped. All you wanted to do was rip into me, Sonny. You know what your problem is? You
what?
Don't know how to compromise.
I don't know how to compromise.
Right.
I don't need to compromise. Because you're going to hide behind my sister as long as she's fool enough
Hello.
To stay.
Hey, I'm at Kelly's. I'm picking up dinner, and Elizabeth asked me to call you. Said that she needs to speak to you and see you in person right away, or the world as we know it's going to come to an end. She said that she's been trying to reach you since yesterday, and you haven't returned her calls. It's about business.
Why? Because
she's
there every day.
No, she just left, and she said she was going to check your spot. You would know what that means, and that you should meet her there.
Okay. If you see her, tell her I get there as soon as I can.
You're her husband. Is that what
AJ
you want?
AJ to leave.
What? What is AJ doing in the penthouse?
Penny, I have a family emergency. Do you think that you could cover the rest of my shift?
Sure.
My wife has this amazing ability to look past the facade, to see the person underneath.
I think what you're trying to say, AJ, is she's naive enough to believe all the lies you keep telling her.
Courtney is married to me, not because I tricked her, but because I love her. Now, I chose her over my own family. She chose me over you. Deal with it. I love her. She's the best thing that's ever happened to me, Sonny. And I want you to stay away from her because I don't want one of your enemies deciding that Courtney's a great way to get at you. Or I don't want one of your enemies targeting you but hitting her.
You are not worth the pain and humiliation she's putting herself through on your behalf. Somebody needs to fix that.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Here we go, right on cue. The threats. This isn't a surprise coming from you.
You want a surprise? You want a surprise?
I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid, okay? Your sister doesn't need you. Just stay away from her.
Okay.
That's all.
Well, maybe
no,
I should
no,
tell
no,
you.
No, no, Sonny, no. That's it. AJ, your time is up. Get out.
You too, Jason. You keep your distance. Both of you. I'm warning you. You stay away. Looking at.
Yeah. Keep going. Go ahead.
Courtney works at 10 tonight.
I'll be there. She'll be fine.
I was useful to Sonny. I used to run errands for him. Watch over his wife. Well, supposed to be his ex-wife, but they didn't know the difference. But right, I already told you that, didn't I?
Finish your wine.
So what happens when I run out of insights? You're gonna let me go, or you're gonna make me walk the plank?
Tell me more about Jax.
Jax. What can I tell you about Jax? Jax knows how to enjoy himself. He flies his own planes. Goes anywhere he wants. Oh, he spent a small fortune to help Carly open a nightclub, mostly to get over on Sonny. Did I tell you he was married?
No, you did not.
Yeah, he was married to my lawyer, Alexis. You know, I suppose you're going to want me to tell you about that relationship, huh?
Well, how long were they married?
I don't know. It was for a while. Must be the best divorce in history because they're still friends. Something in my wine.
Just relax. There's nothing to worry about.
Why are you doing this? What is going on?
Don't
But don't try to fight it. Just let go.
Why would anyone want to know this stuff, hmm?
I'm not trying to hurt you. There's nothing to be afraid of.
I want to know when my brother gets a bail hearing, Scott.
Well, now, watch out. You could have just called.
Oh, I did. I did, and they referred me to you here, and I actually preferred to see you in person. I'd like the forensics teams to know that their big shot DA isn't above planting evidence.
No, nobody can fabricate all of this here. See, the blue patches you're looking at, that's luminol. It's a super sensitive chemical that picks up minute traces of blood and body fluids. You know, it's something to do with hemoglobin, iron. I don't get how it all works, but I like the way that lays the story out there for you, because I'm sure, and so are you, that that's going to be Rick Weber's blood. See, what I figure is you guys probably struck him about here. No signs of a struggle, so he probably never came back. So the first blow was the death blow. So who did it? You were lucky.
Scott, you know what? Neither Lucky or I had anything to do with the death, all right?
Oh, okay. So you like to stage phony car accidents and hide dead bodies. It's like a hobby for you guys. I know about what happened between you two a few years back with the undercover guy. You found him dead. You thought you'd take the blame, and you moved the body. Does that sound familiar?
Let me ask you something here, Scott. If you really think I'm a part of this, why have you only arrested Lucky, huh?
Well, because Lucky's the one who staged the accident. But see, you probably think you're smarter than that. The cops would never find out.
If this is an interrogation, I really would like my attorney present.
Okay, well, that can be arranged. Would you take him downtown? Alexis is already down there waiting for you. See, you know, I was hoping... See, well, take it easier. You know, see, I was hoping that we would find, your fingerprints as well as Lucky's, but, you know, I'm sure we'll find maybe a little thread, hair, something, you know. Maybe somebody saw you guys move the body. There are deals to be made, Cassadine. Now is the time to make them. If you want to go to jail for your brother, so be it. But what about your girlfriend? Accessory after the fact, obstruction of justice. Juries today are not so lenient on rich kids. So you have to ask yourself, what has my brother pulled me into?
So some really awful things happened in that attic. Years ago, my mom ended up repressing it. Scott kept quiet. Now, my dad believes that Scott might have been responsible for setting that fire in the attic a few weeks ago.
Then I need to speak to your dad.
Yeah, well, I need to speak to my dad. Everybody wants to speak to my dad right now. He's not making contact.
Does Luke have any evidence that would connect Scott to the fire?
No. Well, what if Rick was blackmailing Scott, or Scott was blackmailing Rick? I know my dad was getting on to something. I think one of them wanted out. By the way, has anybody checked into where Scott went after the night of the rehearsal dinner?
I think the more relevant question is, what happened to your parents after the rehearsal dinner? Where did they go? Why did they disappear?
You don't need to be worrying about my parents.
Your parents would want me to get you out of this, Lucky, at any cost. So where are they, and why can't they be found?
Rick was spearheading the takeover at General Hospital, and Scott was the lead guy fighting against it.
Baldwin is evidence that puts you in the car that someone drove off a cliff with Rick Weber's body in it.
I didn't kill Rick Weber, but Scott Baldwin knows a lot more about what happened with him.
Well, that's great.
So, you know, if I were you, I'd concentrate on Scott.
There isn't a shred of evidence to cast suspicion on him at this time, Lucky.
Actually, there is.
Do you have good credit?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you only think you have? Do you know how to check your credit report and find out?
Uh-uh.
A surprise on your credit report could mean you'd be turned down for a mortgage.
Yeah.
A car loan. Even a credit card. Which is why you should log on to freecreditreport.com. Freecreditreport.com will show you how to find out online what's in your credit report, who's been checking it, and whether everything's accurate.
Oh.
So log on to freecreditreport.com today. You're going to do it now, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Now, how about you?
Look closely at history in the making. This is the rarest U.S. $20 gold piece and the single most valuable coin ever struck. It's the only legal tender coin of its kind in existence. Our Treasury Department has just auctioned this coin for a record-breaking $7,590,000, the highest price paid for any coin ever. Now, you can reserve your own 1933 Gold Double Eagle as a 10-mil pure gold proof for only $19.95. What can make one single coin worth millions of dollars? It's a story stranger than fiction. When President Roosevelt ordered the destruction of gold coins in 1933, one single coin escaped meltdown. Then it was stolen, bought, hidden, and finally seized by the Treasury Department and sealed in a vault at the World Trade Center. Again, the Double Eagle escaped fate when it was moved to Fort Knox only 8 months before the terror attack. Now it's official. It has just become the single most valuable coin ever struck when it was auctioned this year for an astonishing $7,590,000. To mark this historic event, National Collectors Mint has released its 1933 Double Eagle Proof. Lady Liberty is magnificently engraved in frosted relief on a brilliant mirror-finish background. On the reverse, the majestic American Eagle hovers in flight as if guiding the amazing journey of the historic coin. Each 1933 Gold Double Eagle Proof comes with an individually numbered certificate of authenticity. The final issue price is set at $39 each. But during this advance release, you can own the magnificent Gold Double Eagle Proof for just $19.95. Each is 24-carat gold clad and is guaranteed to be in proof condition. Orders accepted on a first-come, first-served basis. Strict limit of 5 proofs per caller. Don't miss out on this historic offer. Call now.
Call 1-800-258-1700. Sorry, limit 5 proofs per caller. Call 1-800-258-1700. That's 1-800-258-1700.
Weekdays at 5:30 and 9, watch One Life to Live. A criminal on the loose.
Allison's got a gun. I think she's lost her mind.
Get in the car, and you're driving so I can keep an eye on you.
And it can only end one way.
You think I'm gonna let you leave here alive? I get to decide who lives and who dies.
Get ready for One Life to Live. Watch One Life to Live, weekdays at 5:30 and 9, only on SoapNet.
I know you didn't want to come, but I have something really important.
Are you all right? Did someone threaten you?
I'm fine. No, I'm fine. I overheard something I thought you'd want to know about Alxar.
I shouldn't have said his name to you.
Yeah, well, you did. And it's a good thing, because last night when I was closing up Kelly's, I overheard Roy DeLuca speaking to a man named Alcazar. They were talking about Sunny. They had no idea I was there, Jason, I swear. But the point is, this Alcazar, he clearly is an enemy of Sonny's.
We know all about him.
Okay, did you know that he has what Sonny wants more than anything? He said that Sonny will never touch him because he has what Sonny wants more than anything in the world.
You were right. He tried to escape. Don't worry, we'll be able to keep him here until you learn everything you want to know.
Well, tell Morales is being handled. Until then, redirect the shipment. Thank you.
What? Your sister.
Where's AJ?
He's not here.
Oh, he was. Is he all right?
He left on his own, if that's what you're asking. I didn't throw him out. My men didn't lay a hand on him.
You promised me that you would stay out of this, but you couldn't, could you? Did you tell him? Does he know that my night job is stripping?
Hey. Good, how you doing? I think it's
it's a good idea to leave Nicholas and Lucky in there alone?
Yeah, it's one of my better ideas.
You know, they're just in there syncing up their stories.
Well, it's too late for that because the evidence is just blowing their whole stories apart. See, I just lit a fire under Nicholas. Now I gotta just let it spread a little bit.
Does it bother you at all that these are Laura's sons and Lucky is Bobby's nephew?
Yes, Mac, it does bother me. I hope this whole thing is an accident, but I got a job to do. What am I supposed to do?
Look, Felicia said that Bobby's out of town. Have you spoken with her?
No, I haven't.
Well, you'll like this. Miss Davis?
Commissioner.
Preliminary results back. It's Rick Weber's blood up there in the attic. That's where he was dealt a death blow. Your client and his brother put him in a car and drove him off the cliff to cover up the murder.
This is an interesting theory. However, I'm more interested in what inspired you to search the Scorpio attic.
Looks like the forensics team pulled up a hell of a lot of evidence.
It's the worst they could find.
A fingerprint we missed? Maybe one with Rick's blood on it? Another problem is the cop that pulled us over. He can place us with that body.
That's not that big of a deal. His name was on the ticket, right? Pay him off.
What do you mean, pay? This is getting too complicated, man.
No, it wasn't that complicated when you were protecting Gia from that DUI.
Wait a second. That wasn't murder, all right?
This may not be either. It might have been self-defense.
Okay. Then why hasn't Mom or Luke shown up to say that? Right. Answer me that. If they weren't involved, if it was someone else like Scott Baldwin, they would have been here the second you got arrested. You know that.
Maybe they don't know.
Let me ask you something, and I'm serious about this. What would be the harm in us cooperating with Scott Baldwin?
No, Nicholas. I'm not gonna let Scott Baldwin accuse my father of murder. What's going on with you? Did he say something? Did he say something to you?
He threatened to go after Gia, all right? Listen to me. We conspired to cover up what may have been a murder. We tampered with evidence. That is something Scott can prove. Okay, now I can handle whatever's ahead, but I do not want Gia pulled in any further.
All right, then run, okay? Take her to Europe.
I'm not gonna run. First of all, I am not leaving you, okay? Secondly, Scott is not gonna stop going after Luke for this. Now, you know your dad would not let you go to jail. I'm telling you, he's gonna walk through that door and he will confess.
We don't know what happened. Dad's not the only one that's on the run. Maybe Mom killed Rick.
I ordered a search of the Scorpio attic after I found the boys up there. You know, when Luke and Laura's wedding didn't come off, they went right up there instead of going to the reception.
Apparently so did you.
I didn't pretend to get a phony phone call from Laura in Vegas.
Allegedly.
And I didn't stage a car crash to hide evidence, and I also didn't, you know, draft my girlfriend to lie to the cops.
Except for one fingerprint that could have been left in Rick Weber's car on any number of occasions. I haven't seen anything here resembling proof of those allegations, and you still haven't answered the question, what were you doing leaving Luke and Laura's non-wedding, heading straight for the Scorpio residence, right up to the attic?
That's the reason why I'm back in the district attorney's office. Good instincts.
And a lot of answers, except the big one, motive. Why would Lucky, why would Nicholas, why would anyone we know want to kill Rick Weber?
You'll never think of a yeast infection the same way again. Monistat introduces the one-dose ovule, a soft gel insert that goes straight to the infection. It's part of the Monistat 1 combination pack, which brings you fast relief that starts immediately. Not so with that Diflucan pill, which has to go through your entire system, so relief can take up to 24 hours. The Monistat 1 ovule combination pack. The kind of relief you expect from the number one doctor-recommended brand.
Your pet's same exact heartworm and flea medications delivered to your home, saving you time and money.
It costs less than buying from my veterinarian.
It only takes a phone call.
I saved a visit to my vet's office. I didn't have to leave home.
Pet Meds delivers my pet's medication right to my door.
It's cheaper and more convenient than buying from my vet.
I save time and money.
1-888-PET-MEDS. We deliver savings and convenience on HeartGuard, Advantage, Frontline, and all other pet medications. Call to order now or order online.
We're showing off the practicality of Scott Tissue in a place where common sense reigns supreme.
In Scotland.
I like the name.
Let her rip! Every roll has 1,000 sheets.
1,000 sheep?
Not sheep. 1,000 sheets.
And it's soft as a lamb in April.
Here you are.
Thank you. Look what she gave me.
It's too good for you.
It's mine.
Everyone here agrees. You should get it for your clan.
Scott Tissue, common sense on a roll.
Was this kilt thing your idea?
Home haircutting just got better with the new Clip and Trim by Wahl. Snap-on combs and contour design make styling a breeze. But the best part of the new Clip and Trim,
don't forget my neck,
is the built-in detail trimmer making cleanup around the ears, sideburns, and neckline a snap.
Hey, honey, how about a little trim for me?
The new Clip and Trim, the only all-in-one clipper and trimmer by Wahl.
Frank Ryan is a man of many faces. Ryan's Hope, coming up next on SoapNet.
Digital cable from Time Warner offers value that can't be beat.
Crystal clear digital picture and sound.
Even more HBO and Showtime.
Press guide and select a show.
Imagine over 200 channels.
Local customer service. Rack 'em.
Time Warner Cable, the very best in TV, keeps getting better.
Hey, TMC, give me great movies and great stuff.
What do you want?
Hi, sugar.
I want you to run away with me.
My God. Scare me.
Hello.
Hello, Clary.
Shock me.
I got my eye on you.
Make me smile.
Cool. The Movie Channel.
It's the stuff movies are made of.
Open your heart to the Love Stories channel.
For a minute there, I thought you were making a pass at me.
From the first kiss to the last dance. Relive the romance. Commercial free, all day, every day.
You're a little strange, but cute.
The Love Stories channel. Escape to romance.
The longer we go on like this, the guiltier we look. Now, we have to give Scott something.
Oh, give him whatever you want. But don't expect me to back you up because I'm not going to implicate my parents.
You guys having a nice visit?
Yeah, Scotty, I always enjoy talking to my brother.
Well, is there anything that might interest me?
No.
So that's what Alcazar told Roy, that he has something Sonny wants more than anything in the world. Do you have any idea what this means?
It means you need to stay out of this. Alcazar is as bad as they come.
I wasn't listening on purpose. I swear, but aren't you glad I heard? I mean, this way you could have some...
Let me tell you something. If Alcazar would have spotted you, you wouldn't be here. Elizabeth, you would have disappeared, and this time there would be no chance for me to find
okay,
you.
Okay, Jason, I'm sorry. I get it, okay? I'm sorry. Next time I'm put in that position, I'll plug my ears and start humming.
No, next time you see Alcazar or someone dangerous, you get the hell out. Do you understand? Never mind eavesdropping or warning me. You shouldn't be involved in any of this.
So this is you telling me what to do?
No. I don't want you to die. That's what it is. And I'm asking you not to risk your life for me.
Maybe I want to.
What? Did you like getting shot? I mean, you remember how fast it happened, how surprised you were? What if the bullet was 3 inches over? I've held you once and watched you bleed. I can't do it again.
First of all, I didn't ask AJ to come here. He turned up at my door to return my jacket. He said he found stuffed in a closet. So he figured maybe I paid you a visit, and he told me never to come back.
Did you tell him that I work at the Oasis?
No.
Sonny, it would ruin my life if you did.
Yeah, what life? You're running around in circles telling lies on top of lies to justify staying with a parasite who's living off your money and waiting for you to clean up his messes.
He never asked me to do this, okay? And it would kill him if he found out.
Do you hear yourself? You just admitted AJ's weak. He cannot give you a life. How many times can I... By stripping? Is that... That's the kind of life you want? You know why? The only reason you're stripping is because your so-called husband is too pathetic to pay for his mistakes.
I am supporting the man that I love.
I told you. I would take care of Coleman. I'll give him the money.
God, what else? I don't want to owe you. Okay, I don't want you thinking that you can control me. God, obviously, I would rather take off my clothes for money than to ask you for help.
You're not asking. I'm offering.
No, you know what? I made the choice that I could live with.
Yeah, I know. You make choices. Just like I make mine. You know why I chose this life? Do you know why I am who I am? I never want anybody to touch me or the people that I care about. And you keep letting Coleman jerk you around. You know what you're doing? You're letting him spit in my face.
Oh, God, Sonny, everything is just not about you, okay? And this particular thing is about me making sacrifices for my marriage. The man that I love, I'm keeping my husband out of jail. God, haven't you ever made sacrifices for someone that you love?
Do you really love him, though? Come on. Huh? Do you really love him, or are you just afraid because you made a mistake that is spiraling out of control? Okay, you know what? I don't know how long I can sit on this.
No, you promised me that you would stay out of this.
Yeah, but you know what? I've been thinking about it, and I've had a lot of time.
No, you promised me.
I know I promised you.
You promised me that you would let me deal with this in my own way, that you wouldn't get involved, and you wouldn't interfere. You have to keep that promise, Sonny.
I don't know if I can.
You know, don't mind us. We're just gonna, we'll go set up in the kitchen for dinner. Come on.
No, I'm leaving. As a matter of fact, I'm late.
Okay, what happened? Huh?
AJ showed up here, telling me to stay away from Courtney because I'm not safe to be around. And then Courtney showed up scared to death that I was going to tell her husband what she does at night to pay for his debt. Now, she wasn't afraid for herself or what being married to AJ has turned her into. She was crying because she's afraid to lose him. AJ is not worth it.
You know what, Sonny? One day AJ's gonna cross a line. Okay, and Courtney will figure it out. She's gonna see all the lies, and this will all be over.
Not for Courtney. There's no way to take away, you know, all the pain AJ's done to her. He's only gonna bring her more pain.
Some of the most powerful motors drive the smallest machines. At last, a compact portable sewing machine with big machine power that lets you sew like a pro. Introducing the incredible new Sewing Genie. This revolutionary compact electronic sewing wonder is ready to sew in seconds. Don't waste space and time setting up big, clumsy machines. Simply place the Sewing Genie on any surface and presto, you're good to sew. Now anyone can repair a tear anywhere. It's so simple. Sewing Genie's revolutionary microtechnology incorporates all the major features and benefits of big machines. Watch, it's so powerful, it easily sews through leather. And its locking double stitch permanently keeps the seams together. So pillow shams turn ordinary into extraordinary. The powerful Sewing Genie's motor sews through any type of fabric without special attachments. Watch, we folded tough denim 4 times and the Sewing Genie doesn't miss a stitch. Yet it glides through delicate silks. Look, it sews the finest lace. Sewing Genie is portable and stores any place. Tailor repairs cost a fortune. Now fix that torn hem like a pro. It's so practical. Sewing Genie makes decorating so easy. Turn the drab to fab. Don't waste money on expensive bulky machines. Sew smart with a Sewing Genie. Order the Sewing Genie with foot power pedal for only $39.95 and receive the carrying case, a $10 value, free. But wait, call right now and get the 64-piece rainbow thread and bobbin bonus pack absolutely free. That's the Sewing Genie, the power foot pedal, the carrying case, and the rainbow thread and bobbin bonus pack, an incredible $60 value, all for only $39.95. Order now.
To order your Sewing Genie, call 1-800-705-9911. That's 1-800-705-9911. Or send a check or money order to the address listed. So call 1-800-705-9911.
I go to town to make a deposition. I come back, I find out you're implicated in Rick Weber's murder.
I didn't kill anybody.
No, you're an accessory after the fact, at least. You watched Nicholas and Lockie dispose of a body, and then you made a false statement to the police.
Taggart, can you please back off her? All right?
Is this your idea of loving my sister, huh?
She didn't do anything wrong,
all right? No, she hooked up with you, didn't she? You know, lucky Gia, she finds her prince, and all you've done so far has made her life hell.
Okay, I gotta ask you something. Is this an official investigation? Or is this just brotherly tongue-lashing? Because if you're doing this as a cop, I want her attorney present. If you're doing this as a brother, you are completely off base.
Guard, you know what? You know, you need an openness.
Okay, okay, look. Let me just talk to my brother alone, okay?
It's fine. I'll be over here.
This is serious, Gia. You know that? Whether you realize that or not, you're gonna need my help.
Wait here. All right.
I swear.
Please, the sooner the better.
Step away from the prisoner.
He's my brother. I'm asking if he needs anything, so back off, all right?
You know, actually, I am going to need something. I need a suit for my raiment. Can you go through my closet?
See you later.
See you again.
How's this for payback? I used to own a strip joint, right? And now my only sister is taking off her clothes to keep her worthless, drunken husband out of jail.
You know what, Courtney's gonna be okay. She is. And even though she doesn't know it yet, she's very, very lucky to have you in her life. Because how many people get to say they've got a real-life guardian angel watching over them? Making sure they're protected.
How's it going, brother? Good to see you, man. You got plenty of seats out front, my man. Cool. There's a 2 grand minimum. Sugar?
Thanks. Give me a beer. No, actually, give me a bottle of water.
So I don't think I've seen you before, man. My name's Coleman. I'm the owner. So, what kind of chicks you get? I get it, man. You didn't come here to talk, did you? No, I'll leave you alone. But, if you see a girl that inspires you, should let me know. Well, any girl except the next act coming up.
And now it's this is reserved for me. You've all been waiting for. Here she is in person, Daisy, desert flower of the Oasis.
Come on,
Do you have good credit?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you only think you have?
Hmm.
Do you know how to check your credit report and find out?
Uh-uh.
A surprise on your credit report could mean you'd be turned down for a mortgage.
Yeah.
A car loan. Even a credit card. Which is why you should log on to freecreditreport.com. Freecreditreport.com. We'll show you how to find out online what's in your credit report, who's been checking it, and whether everything's accurate.
Oh.
So log on to freecreditreport.com today. You're going to do it now, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Now, how about you?
They've been abandoned, abused, and forgotten. They're the animals no one wants. In this country, more than 10,000 innocent animals are killed every day simply because no one wants them. Dogs like Mona, who was abandoned and left to die on a construction site with her litter of newborn puppies. After she arrived at our shelter, she shook uncontrollably for weeks when anyone came near. It was for dogs like Mona the Sponsor a Dog program was created. In many other places, she'd have been destroyed, but not here, because North Shore Animal League America is a no-kill shelter. We've been finding loving homes for thousands of animals for over 50 years. And though it's unlikely Mona will ever be adopted, we refuse to condemn her to death just because she's unwanted. You can help with her ongoing care by sponsoring her. For just $10 a month, she'll be fed, cared for, and loved for the rest of her days. Call right now to sponsor a dog who needs you. You'll receive a certificate, a picture of your sponsored dog, and a free gift if you use your credit card, which puts your sponsorship to work immediately, saving the life of your sponsored dog and other animals you'll be helping for only $10 a month. Lacey's going blind. Honey was badly abused, and Oreo suffers from seizures, but they do not deserve to die. These animals and many others have known a lifetime of abuse and rejection. Our Sponsor a Dog program is making sure it never happens to them again. But we need your help. Please, call now to sponsor a dog. Someone like Mona is waiting.
When soap opera superstars Lisa Rinna and Ty Treadway talk shop, it gets personal.
Come on, all you soap punks do it.
I don't.
Every chance you guys get, bingo, the shirt comes off.
Only when the story calls for it. You're not being fair here, Lisa.
Right. I wouldn't force you into that whole soap punk stereotype.
Oops.
Lisa and Ty bear all on Soap Talk. Today at 11, only on SoapNet.
Number 29, a beeper. Number 30, a key. Wonder why I wasn't on the keychain with the others.
It looks like a locker key.
Leave it. DA wants to look through this stuff personally.
Idea to stage that accident or to be a witness, okay? That's what this whole relationship has been about from day one.
Oh.
What can you do for Nicholas?
Right. And you have so much experience, don't you? Where's your relationship, big brother?
Now, what has that prince done for you lately besides put you in harm's way time after time after time? That is not what you do to somebody you love.
When are you gonna understand that we are happy together? His life isn't perfect, and neither is mine, but we are better together than when we're apart.
Okay, Taggart, I'm running out of patience. All right, you want to charge me with something? Do it. Other than that, you're wasting my time.
Leave. But don't go too far, all right? You'll be hearing from me.
We gotta go.
Returning to the scene of the crime? Why don't you tell me what really happened here, Scott, and exactly what you did?
Hey.
Hey. Has it been busy?
Usual. Some guy came in looking for Xander. He's wondering if you would know where he is.
I don't know where Xander is.
Probably the last person he'd tell.
How are you?
A friend. Sunny.
Yep.
You know, having bad taste in men, it's kind of like a rite of passage for girls. No, it's how we learn. You may get your heart broken, but you survive. So will Courtney.
If I wasn't Courtney's brother, AJ would have left her alone.
Okay, you know what? She could have made it easier on herself, too. She could have told AJ what this slime club owner was doing.
She deserves this mess, is that what you're trying to say?
Sunny, listen to me. I'm just saying, you cannot be responsible for the choices other people make. Courtney's in this situation because she ignored good advice, and she decided she was going to marry this screw-up anyway. Okay? He messed up, and this is how she's trying to fix it. Hey, honestly, I do believe that it's going to turn out okay. It's going to work itself out.
Yeah.
Dinner's ready. We'll be eating in the kitchen.
Okay, we'll be right there, buddy.
Okay. Hey.
What?
Don't worry about Courtney, okay? Jason's watching her. Everything's gonna be fine. Okay?
Double the size so you can pick up and trap more dirt, dust, and hair in half the time. Swiffer Max.
Now you can actually make pores look smaller. Neutrogena Pore Refining Cleanser. Microbeads and alpha hydroxies exfoliate. Beta hydroxies clean deep into every pore, making pores look smaller. The smaller your pores look, the more beautiful your skin looks. Neutrogena Pore Refining Cleanser.
Oh, those poor kids. How many times have you heard those words? But while you're going about your busy day, one child is all alone. While you're showing off your fresh produce, one little boy is hoping for scraps. While you're griping about the cost of prescriptions, one little girl will never see a doctor. While your children are in school, one little boy is learning from the streets. 30,000 children die every day They die from malnutrition. They die from bad water. They die from no medical care. They die from being poor. You can help save one of these poor little kids for 80 cents a day, less than the price of your morning coffee. Call. Ask us to send you the picture of a child like Samuel, Paloma, Igor, or Raisa. Now, I'm sure as you see them on TV, we'll find somebody to sponsor them, but for every child you see here, there's another one who's waiting, a child who's hoping to hear these words.
Você ganhou padrinho. Dá abraço.
Your 80 cents a day can mean that Helena has nutritious food, that Natalia can see a doctor, that Jacqueline goes to a decent school. The only crime these kids ever committed was being born poor and being too young to fend for themselves. Please, open your hearts. Call Christian Children's Fund. We'll send you a picture of a little boy or a girl you don't know, but will. One of these poor kids is waiting for your call.
Christian Children's Fund is one of the oldest and most trusted child sponsorship charities because so much of your money goes to help the children who need it.
I'm made of skin and bones.
I'm made of muscle.
My imagination.
I'm made of skin and bones.
What's inside me?
Love.
Honesty.
And truth.
We are made of many things.
Please help prevent child abuse.
I am strong.
Powerful.
So what are you made of?
Next General Hospital.
This is a photograph of you with blood on your shirt.
It's your call, sweetheart.
Oh, boy, if Edward would just die.
Stop it! I didn't plan it like this.
What is it?
Wondering who'll stop by to chat with Lisa and Ty on Soap Talk? Then click soapnet.com to get a complete... Up next, follow the legacy of the Ryan family with back-to-back episodes of Ryan's Hope. Then stick around for All My Children, only on Soapnet.
In the David Westerfield murder trial is in guilty on all counts.
We, the jury in the Bevan title cause, find the defendant, David Allen Westerfield, guilty of the crime of murder.
The verdict came on the 10th day of deliberations. The announcement brought tears from Danielle Van Damme's mother. Brenda Van Damme hugged her husband Damon as the verdict was read. Reaction to the jury's decision is still coming in. Police Chief David Bejarano said he was pleased with the verdict.
Again, mixed feelings. We still, unfortunately, we lost Danielle. But on the other hand, we're relieved that this person was found guilty and will not have the opportunity to harm another victim.
The penalty phase of the trial is scheduled to begin a week from today. The jury must decide if Westerfield will get life without the possibility of parole or the death penalty. We'll have complete details on the verdict and reaction to it on 10 News Live at 5.
Are you all right? Did he hurt you?
Get him out of here, man. Make sure you're back inside.
What are you doing here?
We'll talk about this outside. Come on.
No. Sonny sent you, didn't he? Did he order you to sit around here all night and watch me?
The MRI's back. Still waiting on the cardiac enzymes and lights.
What does it show?
Acute intracranial bleed. It's fortunate that you two were there and Edward was brought in quickly.
How's the motor function?
Significantly impaired at this point.
Meaning?
I can't tell you what the residual deficits will be.
Speak English. How bad is it?
Your grandfather's in critical condition. We have him on a ventilator to assist his breathing, and other than that, all we can do is hope and